Good morning, welcome to Nifty Prediction. To join my WhatsApp group, I'm charging 500 rupees per month. You will get live predictions as well as calls in the group, and the levels of the Nifty future also you will be getting updated on the live market. Let's go to the Nifty, how it is traded today. Nifty ended up in the positive 11,604.55, 82.75 points in the positive, 0.72% in the positive. Opened around 11,538.45, low went around 11,516.75, high went around 11,618.10. Let's go to my prediction review as well as my WhatsApp group call. This is the WhatsApp which I have sent yesterday itself around 10:57. I'll explain you with it. This is a positive zone target one, which is 11,613, that is got it today, and the target which 11,644, not having a big difference, but today the negative zone target one also got it, which is 11,538, and the negatives of the target is not huge, which is the points difference are very much around 16 positive and 27 in the negative, which means if you combine both two target and take the average, it gives exactly today's low 11,516. If you take the average of those two, that also I have sent it in my group later today. Nothing but it has, if you take those two, if you take those two average, which gives 11,516, that is what exactly low today. And so that is what the exact these two average. How we derive this? The par value, which is nothing but the par value, is anything 11,582. What this is indicating normally, if the pre-opening is below that level, means the market is activating the negative zone. So the first target and the second target normally try to hit. Most of the time, the first target will get hit, but the points is very less for comparison. Comparing 11,582, today's pre-open is very much in the flat zone, which is almost near to the target one in the negative zone, which is 11,538. So if we take that 11,538, almost exactly there today, 11,538, that is the pre open exactly, almost the only the meager points only got deferred. If we check that 11,538.37, there is 45, something like that, so which is almost there in the target zone. So after that, if you go for that second target, which is not having much difference, but the average got some more matched with that data. For example, if I show you the chart, you may get understand. This is 17th, so 16th target, which normally we used to trade with the level of, if anything opens in the positive, we used to go with the stop loss of previous closing. This is the basic rule. So 11,511.80. If anything opens in the positive and not breaking this particular level, then it is an indication for the bullish. But as per that chart, which shows it is activated the bearish, but at the same time it is activating the bullish trend as well. So those two reasons activated today. I specifically ask my clients to not to trade, because this is the indication, because the pre-opening indicating the negative zone target with 11,490, it is actually 83, this is actually second target, 11,493, but the first target is almost there, so I didn't mention. And indicating indications are showing the volatile, which means even though it is negative target showing, it might have chances to go towards the positive side, because of it is showing the volatile zone. So that is the reason I would like to specifically not to, that why we are not to, not trading today because these points, because of the negative zone, which the points are very much limited, so around negative 27 points. And this is the another rule I have said so many times in my YouTube video. Anything pre-market opens between 0 to 30 points and not breaking the previous closing stop loss, which is on this specific Wednesday stop loss. Previous closing is 11,500, 1180. So this rule will be applicable because today market is in between that 30 point range and not broken this key level as well, because today's low is 11,516. So which means the pre-opening got activated, the negative zone, and the pre-open is activated the bullish. So which means it is kind of a headache to trade. If anything, if you are going for a bullish and the market may react in the other way. So sometimes I would like to avoid this kind of trading days. That is the reason I want not to trade those three reasons, because pre-opening is indicating the volatile zone as well, so it is kind of a messy. But still, after that, some people will like to trade. So small traders specifically not advising to buy. Safe traders and small traders don't buy, because only for high risk. High risk means the points wise it is, the money wise it is very less, but still we know that it has high risk, because we are buying somewhere around 24 to 26. Even the money wise it is very less, and stop loss is almost 50% and the target is 42. But still we know that most of the time the stop loss will get big hit because due to these ranges. So that is the reason, and exactly that is what happened. The stop losses change after that, once it is moved to 28. After we bought somewhere 24 to 26, it was traded around 24 to 26 for quite some time. After it moved to 28, I asked to keep 23.50 from 12 rupees stop loss, and the stop losses also got it. Then once again it went low to 17.50, so again I asked to buy, because that is how we need to trade. If anything high matches, sometimes it works, sometimes it not works. Today it not worked. Around it got 750 to some 20 range. After that, once again from 20 it came down. So we exited somewhere around 17. So total today we lost it somewhere around 10 rupees 50 paise, and total 3 rupees 50 and 10 rupees, or total 14 rupees. 14 rupees nothing but around 1,000 rupees is the. Because it is going to be a high risk, we know, and 1,000 rupees is a small money, but still it is a high risk trade. So safe trader I and small trader I never asked to buy today. So 1,000 rupees we can able to gain in some other market as well, and the high which I highlighted, which is matching exactly with the data. And this is for the tomorrow's, Thursday's data. The Thursday data indicating positive on the ratio of 9 is to 6, average indicating negative. So which means it is kind of a volatile market it shows, but the 1 is to 2 indicating after downfall, once again it may having chances to recover from the low, or if it is opens gap up means it may fall down from the high. So that is the indication it shows. So it is kind of a volatile market. So initial 2 indicating on the volatile market, and the weightage indicating negative, and absolute frequency evenly poised. Whenever we know the evenly poised comes from, we need to play much more cautiously. Book profit every now and then. Even if you are buying for 10, you need to book somewhere around even 17 or 15, 16, 20 in between. So sometimes that is the way. If even 50% profit if you are seeing, you need to book profit, otherwise that profit may not be able to get it in hand. So that is the indication it shows. But if you know the trend, or if you know the side which negative or which positive side it is going to be, then you can hold it. If you are buying 10, if it is goes 15, 20 or maybe 20, you can hold for a huge profit, or 30, 50 if you know the trend. If you don't know the trend, you need to book every now and then whenever it shows profit, otherwise the profit you may not get in hand. That is the indication which it shows. And these are all the support and resistance levels. If anything breaks that bullish open target level, which is 56 points, 50.70, which is nothing but anything breaks that level, it will become a bullish market. So all we know, the basic rule, once again I'm telling, anything opens in the positive, we need to keep stop loss in the range of 11,594.55. So the stop loss range for the bullish, 11,594.55. This is the anything opens positive, this is the bullish market stop loss, normal bullish market stop loss. If anything opens in between 30, less than specifically on 30 points. On the other hand, if anything opens above volatile level, around 26.70 points, so anything opens 26.70 points above that level, we need to keep stop loss in the overall average stop loss, which is 11,589. This is the surplus we need to maintain, because if it is not breaking this level, then the market will have chances to go bullish. If anything opens in between the volatile level, which is anything less than 26.70, and anything in between 29.20, which is indicating volatile market, so it is going to be a tough to trade, and the points may not move that much in the options. So if it is opening like that, on the negative side, if anything opens below volatile level, which is 29.05, then indicating bearish, the stop loss of overall average 11,609.95. this is the stop loss we need to maintain for the bearish, anything open gap down. But as per the four scenarios, it is indicating volatile, but still this absolute frequency indicating that it might have chances to go bullish bearish, because all three 33.33% chances are there for the bullish side. Flat side, the same 33 points is there, and the bearish side, same 33.33% chances are there. So evenly poised means all three results are possible. We need to play much more cautiously, but and the data which shows, this is the new updation which I given. I would like to show you with the colors which I already updated in my, so I would like to show you this particular range. Scenario 2 we may not need, but scenario 1 we need to watch out. So how to trade with this? Anything pre-opens above 11,538.82, then it is indicating the positive zone, with a target of 11,593 and 11,648. So it is clearly showing that up to the negative is at 65.73 points, which is indicating positive zone. So anything, even if it is opens minus 65 points, which is indicating the direction towards to the positive side of zone, with a target of 11,593 and then the target of 11,648. On the other hand, if the market is opens in the zone itself, 11,648, then the market may have tried to come down towards to the previous around 65 points in the negative side. So we need to watch out this at that as well. So if it is matching with the data. On the other hand, if the pre-open anything below 65.75, which is indicating bearish zone, with a target of 11,502 and 11,465. So all we need to watch out is the range in between these five data. Anything extreme bullish will activate the positive target of 3,695, and then with the high range of 11,741. If anything extreme bearish, which activates the 11,400 negative target of 3 and 11,336. So up to today, we can able to see the range, which is the positive side having limited. On Wednesday we saw negative side having limited, but here the positive side is having limited 44-45 points, but the negative side having 138. So negative side is having little bit weightage, so we need to play little more cautiously. keep one put option at least in hand for the next couple of weeks, or maybe up to some 2 to 3 4 months, like that, up to January 2021, because some kind of a war between India and China may impact the market and may fall down heavily. So let's see how the market is going to give us on Thursday. These are all the support and resistance levels. Thank you.